Solo que no he encontrado a la mujer para mí.
¿Y cómo sería esa mujer?
Mi mujer, señorita López, tiene que amar a la tierra como yo la amo. Domaría bajo las estrellas. Sería una gran canción. Y la canción sería la verdad.
Ya ves, eres un romántico ridículo. ¿Quién se va a acostar con él en la tierra, por favor?
That was a scene from the film Casa de mi Padre, directed by Matt Piedmont and starring Will Ferrell. It also stars Diego Luna and Gael García Bernal as two rival drug lords in Mexico. Oh dear, oh dear, oh dear. Casa de mi Padre is a mashup of genres, the spaghetti western, the tipping the hat to Sergio Leone, and of course grindhouse cinema runs in and out of this particular film too, and so does a lot of other odd moments parodied and staged so wonderfully. Ferrell plays Armando Alvarez, El Cobalde, a man who really has been a coward for all his life in Mexico, and he has an overachieving, successful brother, who I guess is slightly younger than he, in Mr. Luna. And Mr. Luna is played plays Raul, a man who is about to marry a very beautiful woman played by Genesis Rodriguez. And Rodriguez, of course, is a looker in this film, and she's wonderful in the film. And she also happens to be the object of Armando Alvarez's eye. Armando wants her as well. And that rivalry between siblings over Genesis Rodriguez's character is basically the framework of a very funny and hilarious and otherwise thin movie, but the fact that it has all the gags and gimmicks propels it right through to the end, and that's what sustains this film more than anything. The distractions, the side notes, the fake backgrounds, all the other things you see in this film that will make you laugh. There's one moment about halfway through the film that had me in stitches. It was very, very funny, and a lot of other people were laughing as well. Casa de mi Padre runs on fumes in this regard, but it does it well. And Will Ferrell, who is a very good dramatic actor as well as a comedic actor, combines the two and does it well, mostly on the comic side in this film. The film has this unexpected or expected moments of stark violence that remind us that it's not all fun and games here. And even though there are some moments in that violence and the aftermath of it that are funny, Casa de mi Padre goes a long way in making an entertaining experience that much more hilarious. I love this film and laugh a lot, and you will too. I'm Omar Moore for the Popcorn Reel.